Good morning, everybody, and welcome to St John the Baptist, West Byfleet, for this service in which we will be both baptizing young Alexander and planting a tree in celebration of the Platinum Jubilee. Will you please stand for our opening hymn, Word of the Father, the Life of Creation? As we remain standing, the collect, the special prayer that is for today, which is the sixth Sunday of Easter. Let us pray. God, our Redeemer, you have delivered us from the power of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of your Son. Grant that as by his death he has recalled us to life, so by his continual presence in us, he may raise us to life So by his to eternal joy, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Jesus said, I've forgotten the important bit. Alleluia, alleluia. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Alleluia. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, those who love me will keep my word, and my Father will love them, and we will come to them and make our home with them. Whoever does not love me does not keep my words, and the word that you hear is not mine, but is from the Father who sent me. I have said these things to you while I am still with you. But the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you of all that I have said to you. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. You heard me say to you, I am going away and I am coming to you. If you loved me, you would rejoice that I am going to the Father, because the Father is greater than I. And now I have told you this before it occurs, so that when it does occur, you may believe in me. This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Alexander there,
Who knows what his life will hold? To what might God call him? For all of us, like Alexander, like Her Majesty the Queen, God's vocation, God's call on us begins with baptism. This is the point at which God claims us for his own, declaring that we are his children and that he loves us. It's the beginning of a long journey, long we hope anyway, it has been for the Queen, in which God calls us into all kinds of things, many that will surprise us and surprise those around us. We are not our own. And those who have been baptized and called in this way are bound together in this body which we call the Church, whose purpose is together to live and serve God so that our vocation is carried out in company with others. But there is one more thing that I want to say that is really important about this. We're not called to do this by ourselves, and not only with others around us. We are called to do it with God's own help. He comes to us as the Holy Spirit. And when we talk about the Holy Spirit, we're talking about God himself, not some mysterious force. We are talking about the third person of the Trinity, which I'm sure is why Jesus says that we will come to him in that passage we have just read from St. John. God comes to us as the Holy Spirit, our advocate, our backer, our supporter. Now, we do not know what challenges life will present to us. But what Jesus says to us is that we may pursue the vocation that God gives to us and at the same time have peace, because God himself walks with us. Amen. Jesus said, "Let the children come to me. Do not stop them." We thank God for this child, Alexander, who comes to be baptized today. Christ loves him and welcomes him into his Church. So I ask you all, will you support this child as he begins his journey of faith?
We will.
Will you help him to live and grow within God's family?
We will.
God knows each of us by name, and we are his. Parents and godparents, you speak for Alexander today. Will you pray for him and help him to follow Christ?
We will.
Thank you. Let's all stand, I think, at this point. I think Alexander's quite keen to speak for himself, in fact, isn't he? So we come to the decision. So, we all wander far from God and lose our way. Christ comes to find us and welcomes us home. In baptism, we respond to his call. This question is addressed to parents and godparents, but we can all join in the answers. Do you turn away from sin?
I do.
Do you reject evil?
I do.
Do you turn to Christ as Saviour?
I
Do you trust in him as Lord? Do not be ashamed of Christ, you are his forever. Stand bravely with him against all the powers of evil, and remain faithful to Christ to the end of your life. May Almighty God deliver you from the powers of darkness, and lead you in the light and obedience of Christ. Amen.
Amen.
It's this one, though. usually remind parents and godparents of the immense undertaking you have just made. What you have done is you have promised to be the people who have had time to grow up in the Christian faith into which you have destroyed the universe. So, as I said, something has started for young Alexander here. We don't know where it will go, but he'll be continuing his early stages for all the guidance that he needs. Obviously, I'm not ruling out presents on birthdays. It's just not the most important, perhaps the most important. Regular prayers, absolutely required for sure. Okay, faithful and loving God, bless those who care for this child Alexander, and grant him your gifts of love, wisdom, and faith. Pour upon them your healing and reconciling love, and protect their hopes from all evil. Fill them with the light of your presence, and establish them in the joy of your kingdom. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. There is one Lord, one faith, one baptism. Alexander, by one Spirit, we are all baptized into one body. We welcome you into the fellowship of faith. We are children of the same Heavenly Father. We welcome you. Let's welcome Alexander.
Jesus said, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you." Sovereign Lord, your Son has revealed you as our Heavenly Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We come to the end of Christian Aid Week, and we come today to planting a tree. And one of the prayers on the Christian Aid sheet seems so relevant today that I thought I'd use it at the beginning of our prayers. Let us come to the river and be like trees planted by streams of water, putting our roots down deep into God's word, bearing good fruit that will last, not withering from fatigue, stretching out to receive and be a source of healing. Amen. Lord, you have made your church a spiritual family, a household of faith. Through baptism, we are reborn as the brothers and sisters of Christ. Deepen our unity and fellowship in him. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God, our Creator, we thank you for the waiting and the joy. We thank you for new life and for parenthood. We thank you for the gift of Alexander, entrusted to our care. May we be patient and understanding, ready to guide and forgive, that in our love Alexander may know your love. May he learn to love your world and the whole family of your children, through Christ our love. Lord, in your mercy, Hear our prayer. Lord, you sent your Son to give his life as a ransom for the whole human family. Give justice, peace, and racial harmony to the world he died to save. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, you gave your Son a share in the life of a family in Nazareth. Help us to value our families, to be thankful for them, and to live sensitively within them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Your Son drew around him a company of friends. Bring love and joy to all who are alone. Help us all to find in the brothers and sisters of Christ a loving family. Lord, in your mercy. God, our Creator, from whom all life comes, we remember those who have gone before us. Bring us with them to the joy of your home in heaven. Comfort those grieving for the loss of a hoped-for child. Help them to find assurance that with you nothing is wasted or incomplete, and uphold them in your love. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. We bring our prayers together in the words of the Lord's Prayer. And so we pray together. Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven.
Give us today our daily bread,
forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. The kingdom of our
We are the body of Christ. In the one Spirit we were all baptized into one body. Let us then pursue all that makes for peace and builds up our common life. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace. We sing our offertory hymn, God is love, let heaven adore you.
Thank you.
opportunity to remind you that we are now offering both the bread and the wine, the chalice, but whether or not you take the chalice is entirely a matter of your own choice, but that we must insist on no intinction, that is no dipping, okay? The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. It is always right to give you thanks, God, our Creator, loving and faithful, holy and strong. You made us and the whole universe and filled your world with life. You sent your Son to live among us, Jesus, our Saviour, Mary's child. He suffered on the cross. He died to save us from our sins. He rose in glory from the dead. You send your Spirit to bring new life to the world and clothe us with power from on high. And so we join the angels to celebrate and sing together. sustain us as we go forward on our journey. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Well, it says brief notices here. Well, they may not be. There's an awful lot going on at the moment, which is a good thing, you would not agree, after all that time in which nothing was going on. However, I just need a few things to tell you. I hope that some of you may have brought back Christian Aid envelopes. There is a tray, plate, thank you, a plate at the back on which you may place those envelopes. And next week will be good as well, whatever. That's the first thing. However, next Sunday I know one or two people won't be here for the service itself, including Amanda over there, because they will be at St. James Weybridge for a confirmation in which Amanda has been confirmed. So have Amanda in your prayers for this occasion, and if any of you wish to be there instead to support Amanda, Clive will be. I won't hold it against you if you're not here. It'd be great to support Amanda. I think I might be able to leave it there. Oh, I better tell you what's going to happen at the end of the service, haven't I? Yeah, I better tell you what's going to happen at the end of the service. Which is that, after the final hymn, without any further ado, we are going to sing the national anthem. We are then going to process, led by the crucified, by the choir and by the clergy, and that's me, out to the site where the tree is being planted. Please come out and join us and gather around. The rest will be announced then. I know what I haven't done, of course. I haven't done the most important bit, have I? So I'm going to have a quick word with Jan and find out what they've been up to. So, would you just... You have received the light of Christ. Walk in this light all the days of your life. Shine as a light of the world to the glory of God the Father. Amen. I hope that candle will be brought out on the anniversary of Alexander's baptism. And now we are going to sing our closing hymn, Holy Spirit, Come Confirm Us.
Thanks be to God.